So, as I was saying before, they're very visual, and Tingana has decided to go toilet right on the middle of the road, or right in the middle of the road. Again, very visual sign. This is very much his territory. Yeah, shall we play Who Dung It? Little bit of a giveaway there, though. This is just absolutely magic. I think this is definitely the highlight of being here. Oh, there is just something very magical about watching leopards, seeing behaviour you just don't get a chance to see very often. While we're off air, they did have another sneaky mating, so that was what, 10 minutes or so. But as I say, it's more of an average that they say about 15, 20 minutes. So they did have quite a long gap, if you remember when they were moving. So it could be they're going to be moving again. So we're just going to say, just keep an eye on them. While we're allowed in the sighting, we're going to stay. Absolutely fantastic. Now that is going to smell, I promise you that. You're. So, if anybody was wondering if they buried their dung like domestic cats do, no. Sorry, there was a comment coming in from Jen. Oh, put it on the dashboard. Are we close enough to see it there or not? Shall I move over a little bit? I'm just keeping an eye on where the vehicles actually are because the leopards have gone through the bush there. If we just, can you see it there? There we go. So I don't have gloves, unfortunately. And also, I wouldn't want to take all of it because obviously, as I say, it is a visual sign. So we don't want to mess up his calling card. And that's really important when we do take leopard samples, we do leave some behind. But you can see it's very dark. So that's to do with what they eat. So that's a lot of blood content in the dung. So maybe he has actually eaten a couple of days ago. That is very dark. Maybe he had something small because I say that belly didn't look very full. Not quite getting the smell. I think I'm not downwind from it, thankfully. As I say, it's very, very potent. So let's see if we can catch up with them. I'm going to also make sure that I don't drive right through it, so we'll try and angle the wheels so that we don't disturb it. This morning, waking me up, and often my feelings are wrong. I wish I was like Tristan, his feelings are usually very right. He had a good feeling yesterday we were going to see leopard, but hi, Riti, welcome on board. Riti asking, now that we've seen the mating, how long will it be before we see the cubs? And leopards, it's usually about 105 days after the mating. That's if the mating has been successful. So they're coming back towards the road here. And it looks like she's inciting him again, just through the bushes. Sure. So they're really going for it now. What's that been? 10 minutes or so again? You all right? Is there another vehicle wanting to come in? Is there another vehicle wanting to come in?
There's another vehicle.
Is there another vehicle wanting to come in?
I didn't hear anything on the radio though.
Oh, okay. Okay, there's a couple of vehicles. This is actually on the main road now. So there's a couple of vehicles that are trying to pull in here. So we don't actually crowd these leopards too much. Hello. I'm going to pull back so that you guys can have a quick look. Sorry? Oh, okay, sure. No problem. I'll pull back anyway. Just so we don't have too many vehicles around the leopard, especially mating leopard as well. We don't want to disturb them too much. So I'm just going to let these vehicles pass. Again, it's really important to make sure we don't put too much pressure on these animals. And young Eric asking if leopards get annoyed with vehicles following them. They don't seem to. I think when they, if they do, sometimes you can see either the ears flattening or them glancing over the shoulder, and that kind of just means, you know what, you're there, but I'm not overly happy. So then you increase. Oh, the mating again, just through the trees. Sorry. Well done, Senzo. Sure, it's almost like because he's now keeping in one spot, she's almost inciting him every few moments. Absolutely amazing. So, let's see, there is, say, a few vehicles there, so I'm just going to pull back even further. Say the problem is this is the main road, so if people haven't heard what's going on, oops, then they're going to bump into this sighting, and as I say, that's why we don't want to put too much pressure on them. There we go. And like I say, it's our utmost priority to not put the pressure on the animals. So we always watch what they're telling us. And occasionally, you know, we might get it wrong. We might bump into them by accident and they kind of give us a bit of a warning. But as I say, as long as we can back off. But you saw when we were there with them, they were moving around the vehicle. They were very nice and relaxed. So I think with Tingana just putting his nose to the ground and he was on a mission, I think it was more that than the vehicle pressure. So we're back on Impala Plains, and I'll listen out to see if there's another space to go back in to that sighting. But everyone's now heading back for breakfast, which obviously you can understand they'd like to see the leopard on the way back. So we'll hang around here, and as I say, I'll see if we can get us in again. But it has been wonderful to see that behaviour, and like I said before, it's behaviour you just don't get a chance to see very often. I think we've been really, really lucky. And, you know, in the 10 years of working in the bush, seven of those have been in an area where there's been leopard. But really, seeing leopard like this, you only really get to see it in the sands, in the Sabi sands here in South Africa. And to actually spend the time with them. That's only the second time I've ever seen mating leopard. The first time was just outside my bedroom window, and that was a brief moment in the moonlight. So really amazing to see it out during, you know, the morning, really quite amazing. So I'm absolutely thrilled to have spent the time with you guys and the leopards and sharing this wonderful moment. Or even this whole drive with you. It's just been fantastic, and I really hope you've enjoyed it. Oh, it's gone very quiet around here. No wonder. So Michelle asking what the success rate of mating leopards is, and was I hearing them again? Not quite. Oh, they did do it again. I thought I just heard a oh, amazing. But yeah, I think I remember reading somewhere that it takes around 300 copulations to produce one cub. So it might be something in that area. So I'd have to try and find that little fact out again. But it takes a lot to try and produce the one cub. And then obviously the survival rate is also fairly low, really, if you consider. So they can have 2 to 6 cubs. Around 3 or 4 might be the average. We've had Karula, obviously she's had a couple of cubs each time, but that's the cubs that we've seen. We're not sure if it would have been the cubs, because when they first born, as I say, they're about this big, so they're completely helpless and they're completely vulnerable to anything and everything. So she leaves them in the den to go hunt, then they're open to snakes, they're open to jackals, literally anything that can get their jaws around a baby leopard can eat it, and obviously that can happen if they're not very well concealed. So she'll find somewhere like a termite mound and leave them in the hole. They'll find them in a little drainage line, maybe a little scrape just in the bank, something like that. So she'll actually try and hide them as best she can. She'll move them around as well so that her scent isn't pulling predators to the den as well. So there's a lot of things that they try and do to try and limit the loss, but that's why they do have several cubs, because hopefully out of that bunch one might make it to adulthood. Whereas with the antelope kind of put all their eggs in one basket, so they can only really carry Franklin, is there anything sneaking up behind us there? Franklin just went wild behind us. It's not as if I snuck up on them. I've been stationary the whole time. But yeah, antelope put all their eggs in one basket to produce one offspring. But that's really well developed in the hope that that's going to carry on into adulthood. So speaking of antelope, I think Tristan has some for you. So let's see what he has.
We do. We have probably one of the more beautiful antelope that we get out of here. Well, I suppose all of them are quite pretty, but we've got our largest antelope. Let's use that to describe them, which is the kudus. And they're in this morning sunshine. You can hear the Cape Turtle Dove behind me also going at it. And they're just slowly ambling along back into the thickets. Now, they've come out of an area where the last tracks for these lions went into, and they look very chilled, so I don't think they've in any way bumped into lions. So maybe these lions have moved on beyond this, and we've just missed their tracks. Hyena Road is a very difficult place to track. It's very hard and narrow and not easy to find tracks themselves. So a little bit unfortunate, but there's another kudu about to come across the road. I just love their ears. There's my favorite part about them is those massive ears. And of course, they are of use. It's not just because they want big ears. This helps them to hear very well. And when they walk, I love how the head also rocks as well. They almost remind me of that Egyptian song where they move their head around. That's how I always think of the kudu when they're walking. Unfortunately though, they are disappearing into the thickets, as the rest of them are almost gone now. It's just this last one that came across the road. So from here, I'm not quite sure where to go anymore. These lions have walked so far this morning that it's been a bit of a nightmare. We've been tracking them all morning, and goes like this sometimes you just don't get much luck and the lions end up being a little bit ahead of you the whole morning. And I don't know from here where they could have gone, because what's wrong, Nyala? There's a Nyala that's taking his frustrations out. Maybe he's also been tracking lions this morning, but he's smashing his face against a tree, which is probably what I feel like doing as well when I track lions and don't find them. Now of course he's not actually doing that out of frustration. Are you caught in the tree? I think he was horning the tree, which is what they do sometimes when they display to other males. There's another younger male behind them, but it almost looks like he's caught up in it now. I'm sure he'll free himself. There we go. We freed ourselves of the tree. But they do sometimes horn trees and displays to other males. And I think what happened was, unfortunately, all the branches caught behind him. You can see, look, he's now fluffing his back up as well. So he's practicing what's called phyloerection, which is basically to make himself appear larger. So the male that just disappeared off to the left, who's behind the tree there, showing that he is the bigger, stronger male and intimidating that male with its hair and its horns and its ability to smash branches with its horns itself. So that'll be to teach that younger male that he is still the bigger, more dominant male within this grouping. And Nyala are quite interesting because they'll often do this even when there's a female around and she's in heat. You'll find that they'll move around one another in this intricate kind of dance with the hair up and sort of exposed, and they make themselves really appear quite large, and it can go on for quite some time. I've seen it happen for over an hour where they just walked around each other, and eventually they then one just left and the other one stayed and ended up mating with the females. But pretty interesting to think, if we compare that to even the smallest animals like the steenbok that fight with one another for dominance, it's interesting that the Nyala have a more gentlemanly way of settling things and not so barbaric as some of the others, and they're able to deal with it. But they will fight eventually if two males are very evenly matched and they're both physically of a similar size. You will find that they will then go after one another every now and then. Now, I think my favorite part of a Nyala is probably their tails. They have the most odd tail. The tail looks as though it's got a life of its own. So it's big and bushy and sort of fluffy. But when they wiggle or when they flick their tail, the bottom part of it seems to be completely loose. It's almost as though there's no bone towards the end, and it kind of flips and flaps all over the place. So I really enjoy a Nyala's tail. I don't know why. It's just one of those weird things that happens. I can hear some oxpeckers coming over as well. I'm sure they're going to land on the kudu and the Nyalas that are in this area and feed off all the parasites that they potentially have. But what you can see now with this Nyala, which is quite nice, is the camouflage pattern. So you see how the lighter colored legs really blend into the lighter grass area, and then the darker coloration more into the shadow part of the bush. So they actually do blend really well by having that distinct leg color and having it different to the rest of the body, because if they had dark legs, those legs would stick out very easily, whereas now they tend to blend in a lot better than if they were dark. You can see a couple females in the background there as well. Maybe he was trying to impress females by headbutting a tree. They don't look as though they're too impressed, do they? They all look as though they're moving away. Riti, you're asking is it mating season for all the animals at Juma? Riti, no, not necessarily. Things like elephants, buffalo, zebras, lion, leopard, they just mate at any time of the year. As soon as they come into an estrus, they'll be mating, and they don't really worry about seasons. You'll find that the antelopes depends on their duration or their gestation duration, and they'll then have different times that they'll mate. So we know that the impalas were mating around sort of April, May, that area, that's when the rut was in. And then you'll find with other animals that it might be earlier in the, or towards summer, or it might be later in the winter, just depending on their gestation period. So there's a pretty much mating that happens throughout the year between all the different animals. It's not confined to a single season between them all. So now, talking about mating and all these things, I believe Tara has now moved on from her mating displaying leopards, and well, I wonder where she's going. I suppose she's going to head home for some eggs and bacon now.
Yeah, that's, I definitely feel like I've worked up an energy and appetite, sorry, using all the energy. I don't know how the leopards do it on an empty stomach, but we have actually left the leopards. There's a lot of vehicles still on that road, so we've decided just to leave that area completely. Hopefully we might get them this afternoon if they're still around. That'd be amazing. But it really has been a wonderful morning, and yeah, as I say, it just goes to show you've no idea what's going to happen until it unfolds in front of you. And it has just been wonderful. I know a lot of you were excited with anticipation, as I was this morning, about what we might find. And having mating leopards, I think, is definitely up there on one of my top 10 sightings. So really, really magic to share that with you. And I really hope you've enjoyed it as much. And as I say, some really interesting behaviour. I'm certainly going to be mulling that over as well. And it just goes to show, you don't know, nobody knows everything. And the more you actually learn from each other and the more you experience, the more you can actually build on what you do know and learn more. So really quite amazing. And as I say, quite a shock to me. As I say, I've always known leopards, they have the cubs, they become independent, and then they mate. But as we've seen today, that's obviously not always the case. So really interesting. But thank you so much for joining us this morning. And I know we've had some beautiful sightings of elephants as well and some antelopes. So hopefully you've enjoyed quite a variety this morning, as well as the mating leopards. Oh, cherry on the cake, hey? But thank you all so much for all your questions. It's really great to hear from you, from your comments as well. And it is just wonderful. I love Safari Live, as I hope you guys do as well. And I hope you'll join us for our afternoon drive this afternoon. So wherever you are in the world, take care, and we'll see you again soon. Goodbye from myself and all the team here at Safari Live.